Hi everyone, in this video we are talking about suppressing a power source for electric circuit analysis. And we have independent sources, so we have a voltage source on the left here. We're going to say that it's a voltage of V sub S, and it's over the nodes here. And then we have a current source, let's just say it's I sub S. That's great. So how do we suppress it? Well, all we're doing when we're suppressing a source is we are taking its value and setting its value to zero. So the definition of suppressing a source is set the value to zero. And so that means for a voltage source, that would become zero. So if Vs equals zero, that means that there's no voltage difference between the top and the bottom terminal, or the nodes. So that's equivalent to them being directly connected, which is a short. So once it's suppressed, it becomes a short. So we call that a short circuit. All right. And for the current source, we have its value is IS. And if we suppress that source, we are going to set the current value to zero. So IS is exactly zero, and this is amps, the previous one was volts, just for completeness. And if it's 0 amps, it means that no current is flowing between the top and the bottom nodes, so that would be equivalent to an open circuit. Okay, so this is open circuit. When would we use this? Well, we can use it when we're doing superposition, because in superposition, we are suppressing each of the sources, or I guess you would say you're turning only one source at a time on and suppressing the other one, which is making their value zero, so you're only having one input at a time, and then doing circuit analysis and rotating through all the sources, adding them all up. So that's one time we use source suppression. Another time we can use this is for node analysis, when we're trying to figure out how many nodes we have and how many are unknown. And this is source suppression is a technique to help you identify that. In summary, if you want to suppress a voltage source, you set its voltage value to zero, which is equivalent to a short circuit between the terminals. If you want to suppress a current source, we set the current value to zero, which when no current flows, it's equivalent to an open circuit between the terminals. So now you know how to suppress an independent power source, but don't just go around suppressing any source you see. Use your knowledge wisely.